Christ, your kingdom come. Said in our hearts through Mother Mary.
In our hearts through Mother
Mary. Christ, your kingdom come.
In our hearts through Mother Mary.
God is love
all the time.
All the time.
God is love as his nature of our heart.
If you are breathing 2018, okay? And you are able to walk from the bed to church. Amen. Don't be worried, because I'm aware you have not had breakfast. There's a range of combining breakfast and lunch today. Yeah, do our best so that the others will come here, because we want to celebrate. Amen? Yeah, so if you're able to come here, it means you are alive, you are breathing, isn't it? There are some who are not able to wake up today. While there are some who are in the mortuary. There are some families who are burying their dead. Even one who's burying, family who's burying the dead yesterday, somewhere here in Makengo. So, but we thank God he has given us another day, another year. Amen. So, you can raise up both hands and give your mighty hand clap. Human, but was not God. Now, avoid, to erase all these confusions and so on. Okay? Oba Senior is the church over here has tried to put in a statement so that believers who are really searching for the truth can be able to understand or at least grasp what the church teaches. And so, the Theotokos, which means the mother of God, the one who gave birth to God, okay? In Latin, to be Dei Genetrices, like one who generated God, okay? So who gave birth to God. Now, when this dogma was proclaimed in 431, doesn't mean that Mother Mary began being the mother of God from 431 AD. No. When some of you, we know each other as brothers and sisters, but we don't know our parents, isn't it? Yeah. So if I know I have known brother for quite a while, for 5 years, and then but I don't know his mother, isn't it? Then it happens that the mother comes to during his graduation, and the brother tells me, Brother Dunga, this is my mother. I'll be very grateful, isn't it? Unless we are enemies with him. But if we are friends, I'll be very grateful, isn't it? Now, does that mean that the mother of brother or Jogo starts being the just being his mother from 18th of May 2018? Does it mean that way? No. She has always been his mother. Amen. She has always been his mother. From where? From the moment of conception. Isn't it? From the instant, from the moment of conception. Mama Mary, Mama Maria, Auma became the mother of brother. Isn't it? But people come to God to be conscious about it the moment they come to encounter this truth. So, for you and me, we are realizing that this is the mother for Job 2018. But many years before, she has always been the mother. That's what it all means with Jesus and Mary. Mother Mary was always the mother of Jesus, was always the mother of God. But some people come to know the truth, this truth about it, after maybe reading the scripture, after reading some church documents, the experience of mystics and visionaries, and so on. And they come to their consciousness and really Mary is the mother of God. And so, why do we make a statement that Mary is the mother of God? Because Jesus is one with the Father and the Holy Spirit. We have just heard from the second letter, from the second reading, from Galatians 4, verse 4 to 7, that when the appointed time came, God sent his Son. You know, God, the Father and Son were always there, even before creation. But when the appointed time, according to the plan of God, he sent his Son, born of a woman, because it's only a woman who has the womb. Only women are privileged to have womb and breast. Okay? Very important for every human being. So, was born of a woman, subject to the law, to redeem us who are captives of the law, slaves of the law. He redeemed us by that. And then God sent his Spirit into those who believe in Jesus Christ. And that Holy Spirit cries out in us, Abba Father. You see, this is another revelation, a biblical revelation of the mystery of the Holy Trinity. The mystery of the Holy Trinity is intrinsically connected with the divine maternity of Mother Mary. Because at the revelation of the Holy Trinity, they will say you cannot detach the Son from the Father and the Holy Spirit. And so the very reading in the Galatians, which we have just read, already demonstrates that there is a connection between Mother Mary and the Holy Trinity. If there is anybody who knows the mystery of the Holy Trinity and can explain it fully. For anybody to understand fully, see what I mean. At the moment of conception, at the moment of annunciation, conception, when Mary conceived Jesus, the angel was sent by God the Father, and he announced to Mary, the Holy Spirit will come upon you. Okay, say again. There's a third person on the body to you. The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you, and him whom you conceive will be called Holy Son of God. In Luke chapter 1, verse 5. That is another revelation of the Holy Trinity. Again, it is intrinsically connected with the divine maternity, with the motherhood of Mary. So, we find that every time we want, God wants us to understand something very well, then he likens himself to a woman. In Isaiah 49, he says that can a mother, verse 14 to 16, can a mother abandon her own child, the fruit of her womb, the one she breastfeeds? No. But God says, even if this can do that, I swear, I will never abandon you. I will never forget you. He's speaking to each one of us. You may be thinking that God has forgotten about your problems. Or he's answering other people's prayers and not yours. He's blessing other people, not you. No. He made an oath. He can never forget you. Amen? Maybe you will forget him, but he will not forget you. When God wants to express something that's fundamental for our salvation, for our well-being, then he likens himself to a woman. We find all those figures, symbols, signs, especially in the prophetic books, and also in the gospel. And now, how can we know, if we don't have experience of a mother, how shall we be able to understand some things in life? You see, the Messiah, the Savior, would have come in this world, just come and fall down back like an angel. But he chose to do what? To come in the womb. He took flesh from men. Remember, I repeat as I say, there is no Jesus in the flesh without Mother Mary. This is Jesus you are seeing, the disciples saying, we saw him, we touched him, we ate with him. None of the things would have happened like that if he never took flesh from men. And there is no Jesus in the flesh, the incarnate one, the mystery of the incarnation, the Emmanuel, God with us. We could not know him without Mother Mary. And so, that's why the saints tell us that, when somebody abandons Mother Mary, rejects Mother Mary, then he has already moved steps away from Jesus. Away from Jesus. Remember, as per the wisdom of God demonstrated in the sacred scripture, God designed that it is a mother. Before I say that, let me ask you a question. In this world, who knows you best? Who knows you in and out? God, isn't it? Apart from God. Because God is God. Among the human beings, who knows you in and out? Well, who? It's your mother. Yes. It's your mother. Because your mother knows you from the moment of conception. Amen? Now, your father knows you depending on what your mother will tell you. God has given the mother a prerogative, authority, and power to introduce the child to the father. Okay? And also has given the mother the authority and the power to introduce the child to the uncles, aunties, cousins, family, clan, tribe, nation, the whole world. So, who knows Jesus more than anybody else? It's Mother Mary. If we really love Jesus, who are true followers of Jesus Christ, we shall automatically have a devotion to Mother Mary. Remember, Mother Mary does not need our praises because she's not lacking anything. Okay? Amen? She's not lacking anything. You know, sometimes people think that they're doing a favor to God. No. It's not like that. Because you're not lacking anything. Amen. So when we venerate or praise Mother Mary, it's for our own benefit. It's such a specific impression. Because she is full of grace that is overflowing. She's full of grace overflowing. We say, Hail Mary, full of grace. Hail Mary, full of peace. Hail Mary, full of joy. Okay? It's overflowing. And you know, the grace is proportional, usually, to our disposition. The more we abandon sin, the more we are in the state of grace. But the more we embrace sin, the farther we move away from grace. And therefore, Mother Mary being immaculate, without sin, conceived without sin, she has fullness of grace. The grace is full, not to the maximum, until it is overflowing. For us, it's usually depending on what our state is. You can see the prophets, Elijah, Elisha, our patriarchs, Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, our matriarchs, Sarah, Rebecca, all these people. They are great figures. Okay? They are great men, righteous people. They did things, wonderful things, incorporated with God's plan of salvation. But none of them was full of grace like Mother Mary, because they had sinned. They sinned against God. At one point or another, they offended God. And they had to repent. God had to forgive them. Amen. It is only Mother Mary among all prophets and matriarchs and the disciples and apostles. She is the only one from the generation, from Genesis to Revelation, who never offended God. If you have come across her, then you can say. But according to our church fathers, amen, doctors of the church and mystics, they have said they have not found any. And you know the Bible has no sacred cows. You know sacred cows? Sacred cows are people who cannot touch. Even if they do something wrong, you cannot condemn them. Even if they do wrong, you cannot correct them. If you dare correct them, they will shoot you. So those are all sacred cows. But remember, the Bible has no sacred cows. Even however a great man is a woman before God, even Moses, when he sinned, the Bible says he sinned. Isn't it? He doubted. Peter, I'll build my church on this rock. When Peter sinned by denying Jesus, the Bible writes that is. They couldn't see that this man has a very high status, no? He's a leader, they should have hidden that sin, no? Not say that. So it's only Mother Mary. According to sacred scripture, there's no, nothing she did that was an offense before God. Now we learn from Mother Mary to treasure. You know, always in the Gospel of Luke, you will mention that Mother Mary treasured all these things in her heart. When they are looking for the child, Jesus found her, he found him, and he said, How did this thing for you and my father have been searching for him? Jesus said, did you not know that I was supposed to be in my father's house? The scripture says Mother Mary treasured that in her heart, treasured, pondered over it, reflected over it. She did not deny. She did not dispute. Okay? That aspect of treasuring. And see, the word treasure means it's something that you value. If it's not something you value, you want to call it a treasure. Okay? Again, when Simeon the prophet, the brightest man in the temple, was uttering some prophetic words under the influence of the Holy Spirit, he directly said to you, the mother of this child is worse than it pierced your heart. It was a very hard. Unless you are prepared to receive such a message, you will hit the person who is telling you those messages. But Mary, in her treasured heart, put that in her heart, reflected over it, because the will of God. When you are told, you will conceive and bear a son of God. Finally said, I am the handmaid of the Lord. Let it be done to me according to your word. When the shepherds came, and we are talking things about Jesus, which they were told by the angels. She had, and just had, and she treasured that in her heart. So there is this aspect of treasuring, pondering, accepting the word of God for what it is, and reflecting over it. Then with the time, with the revelation comes, you come to understand. Because you may not understand everything that God says about yourself. Some of the things, you may see, no, this is not possible. This cannot happen. Amen. But see, God at them. So that accepting the word of God and reflecting over it will give you opportunity when the time of fulfillment comes. Yeah? For example, Mary accepting that Simeon's prophecy in the temple when Jesus was presented the temple on the 40th day. That accepting that message and treasuring it and reflecting over it, it gave her the grace she needed to stand at the foot of the cross. Otherwise, like other disciples and apostles, should have run away. So when we accept, like Mother Mary, what God is saying, even if we do not understand it fully, when it comes to time of fulfillment, we shall have the guts to withstand the storms. Amen? Mother Mary is the most perfect disciple, most perfect apostle, most perfect Christian. So in most cases now we start with others because Mother Mary is fasting everything. First in holiness, isn't it? You see, the holiness of men surpasses the holiness of all the saints. You imagine St. Francis how holy he was. Padre Pio, St. Teresa, Margaret. You combine all their holiness. It's not even half. It's not even half of Mary's holiness. You can imagine. The martyrs, people who shed their blood for faith. You can see the suffering they went through. The Ugandan 22 Ugandan martyrs. Charles Luanga, Lumba, and the others. Saint Bakita, Joseph Bakita from Sudan. Blessed Bakancha from Congo. Blessed Ahimahite Clementine from Congo. Isn't it? And many others who are not recorded. You imagine that you put together all the suffering that is happening. It is not even half of the martyrdom of Mother Mary. That's why she's called Queen of Martyrs, Queen of Prophets, Queen of Saints. Amen? Queen of Martyrs. The litany tells it all. But the litany is just a test. We cannot exhaust all the titles of Mother Mary. It's just a test. Now I want to give testimony. Which this one is I've seen this person. I've seen her. I've gone to her place because of what I had and seen for myself, witnessed, and I've been with her on many occasions. This young lady, she's a mother of four children, but just very slim. You cannot know that she has four children. Mother Mary appeared on her, to her, okay, 2009 February, okay, 9, at 3 hours in the night, in her small grass-thatched house. Now, she saw a bright light that even it was too much for her. She started repenting. Said, now the world has come to an end. But Mother Mary, because when Mother Mary is going to appear to you, or any saint, even a Padre Pio, even a position, the Lord has to prepare you, otherwise you can die. So, in that conversation with Mother Mary told her, because she asked, who are you? But what Mother Mary told her, that my children are suffering. This husband is somewhere in Kenya. This lady I'm talking about. She's called Dada Stella. She's called Stella. She said, Mother Mary said, my children are suffering. Some have sickness. Some of them are having problems with their family, poverty, and so on. I am now saying, when my children come to this home, don't just any. Minister to them. Give them whatever they want. That is what I'm saying to you. And you will do this, and all over the world you will go. Okay? And then she asked, who are you? Who are you? You know, sometimes Mother Mary takes 16, sometimes 3 months to answer that question. Not that she doesn't know, but she's giving time for this mystic to be ready to receive the message. Remember at Lourdes, in 1858, 8th of December, 25th of March, she said, I'm Immaculate Conception. Isn't it? Yeah. Now, this lady, when she asked, who are you? Mother Mary said, I am the mother of God. I am the mother of God. That's the title afternoon together. And then afterwards, Mother Mary. So all that Mother Mary came, told her within that period, that apparition. No, during apparitions, now outside time. But all these things have been unfolding up to today. Up to today. Now, she was put to test. Okay? Few weeks later, after that apparition, 12 men came in her home. 12 men, mad men. Okay, you know, mad men. And they were in her home instead. They were asked, where have you come from? You know, they are not answering correctly. Or they are not answering. Because they are mad people. Where is your identity card? Nothing. So they were not, nobody was able to trace where they come from and who they are. But they were there. They have bodies and souls. So they were eating. So this mama had to prepare food for them every day. Breakfast, lunch, and supper. Has to bathe them every day, bathing. And vest them every day. And has to pray for them every day. First day, second week. Happy. 60 days. 3 months, I mean 2 months, 60 days. But in the course of that period of time, these people, of course, as mad people, they were also very fun, doing their own things. Sometimes you could prepare food, and after serving them, or before serving, one takes the pot and pours it. And then now she has to cook again. Sometimes she has had her clothes on the line there. Another one will take and then put on the head. Because one day, what's happening this one? You can imagine. She went all through that, but she accepted. Amen. 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 The grace that Mother Mary gave her that night, only once, gave her the grace to be able to nurse people who are strangers, madmen, who are not related to her. They don't know how to say thank you and so on for 60 days. And at the end of 60 days, each one of them came. Say.
You can't.